Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the lead editorial. And today's lead editorial, it relates to Indian economy, and this editorial relates to one of the primary problem that currently we are facing. Now what is this problem? The problem is with respect to the job generation. Now why this problem is important? Now this problem is important because, first of all, India is becoming literate, India is becoming skillful with every passing day, and we are adding a lot of population of the skillful youth to the job market, but the job market is actually getting shrunk day by day. Job market is not offering the jobs to the youth. So this is one of the biggest problem, that the skillful youth and the educated youth is not able to find the job. The second problem associated with the job generation is that we are also facing a situation and a scenario whereby our agriculture sector is not remaining productive from employment perspective. Now what is the meaning of productive from employment perspective? It means agriculture sector is no longer having the capacity to absorb the youth of the nation. Now the reason for that is agriculture has become lot mechanized, and agriculture is not yielding in terms of the productivity when we compare it with the other sectors. So it has become less productive. So that is another reason we are adding a lot of population from the agriculture sector. So we need to work on the agriculture sector. We need to create opportunities for the people who are actually youthful and skillful. And thirdly, we are also facing up a scenario whereby the Indian woman is getting educated and skillful, but she is devoid of the job opportunities. Now how all these developments are not good for the Indian economy, and what actually needs to be done in order to cater the changes that we are currently facing? Agriculture sector not absorbing, youth looking for the employment, and the woman is again looking for the employment. Now how this situation can be catered to? Now this situation can be catered to provided, first of all, we really need to look out at the lacuna areas. Now the biggest lacuna area that has been pointed by the author is about the inverted duty. Now what is this inverted duty? Inverted duty is the duty, is the pinch that the manufacturers in India feel. Now what is this pinch about the inverted duty? Now inverted duty primarily means, now supposedly you are buying some product, you are buying a complete product. Now let us take the example of an electronic good. Now if you will be importing that good in India, in that case the custom duty that will be imposed on that good, it will be less in comparison to the ingredients by which it is made. If you will be importing those subparts, and if you will calculate the custom duty, that will actually be more. It was less in the case of the final product, but it is more in comparison if you will import the subparts, if you will import the raw material. So what it means? It means that India is acting like a market where the people should be actually adopting, should actually be buying the final product rather than buying the raw material. Now if India will have expensive raw material, in that case the manufacturing will not take place. And if the manufacturing will not take place, it will affect the job generation. So in order to have the effective job generation in India, we need to do away with this anomaly of inverted taxation system. This has already been rectified. Now the sectors in which we don't have this inverted duty phenomena, those sectors are really doing good. You have the example of the automobile. And already some changes has been brought in with respect to the electronic sector. But there are numerous other sectors that are reeling under the problem because of this inverted duty. So we need to remove this inverted duty. So it becomes favorable for the manufacturers from India to manufacture the final products, so that these products can be sold in the Indian market. Now, what else we can do with respect to job generation? Now, another thing that we can do with respect to job generation is about creating clusters. Now, clusters also mean that we should be focusing on creating growth poles and growth centers. Now, currently, what we are having, a lot of manufacturing centers, and these manufacturing centers plus the traditional manufacturing centers, if we add both of them, they amount to about reaching the figure of 7,000. So we have 7,000 such places in which the manufacturing is being done, but these 7,000 places haven't been clustered. Well, now what it means being clustered? It means that they are not in the same place. Now, if they will not be at the same place, the forces of agglomeration, the forces of centripetalness will not work. If that will not work, the job will not be generated. So this is the second thing that we need to work on. We need to actually strengthen our clusters, because strengthening clusters will invite a lot of investment. It will make it easy for the manufacturers to set up the manufacturing plants in the clusters, because the cost of setting up actually declines, because you have the availability of the raw material, you have the availability of the labor, you have the availability of the skillful people. So this is the second thing that can be done in order to work with respect to job generation. Now, the third important thing that needs to be done is to work on the different social sectors. We need to work on the health sector government, because we are just spending 1.2% of the GDP, and this really needs to be increased to 2.5% of the GDP. This will give a boost to the health sector, and this will also improve the overall the health and the nutrition of the citizens. And apart from that, it will also add to the employment. The health is the one sector. Apart from that, we actually need to actually resort to the Keynesian theory. Now, what does the Keynes theory say? It says, in the time of turbulence, in the time of challenge, it is the government, it is the state, and the institution that should come forward, because they have the responsibility, they have the authority, both the things they have, responsibility as well as authority, to protect its citizens. So let us not leave the things to the market, where a normal citizen just will be treated as a customer. Let us rein in ourselves. Let us wield the authority that we actually possess and offer to the citizens what they actually desire and demand. So a lot of investment in the sectors like infrastructure, in the infrastructure like health, like police, actually really help to do a lot. Now, apart from creating clusters, the government also needs to create positive policies for labor intensive sectors. Now, labor intensive sectors like handlooms is there. Now, apart from handlooms, we have the footwear industry. That's again, then we have the furniture industry. So these are the industries in which the government should be really investing in. The investment will help to generate this job, and this is something that India is looking for. Because if we will not employ the youth, it will create a lot of distrust, and we will actually not be able to channelize the potential that the youth actually possesses now. The literacy rates have shortened up, the enrollment rates have increased, but we actually need to meet up all these positive things with the positive thing in the market. In the market in terms of the job that we should be able to provide to the youth. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. So this was all for the class. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.